Okay, so we will begin with the fourth unit, that is triangulation adjustment. A very small unit, at least it takes 2 hours. In a single stretch, I will complete this whole unit. Okay, so what are the triangulation adjustment? See, before going to that one, say you have a closed traverse. Okay, compass serving, you have already done this one. Okay, closed traverse. If going for this pentagon, I will take the this one, rectangle. Okay, the total angle is how much? 360 degree. Okay, we know that the angle A plus angle B plus angle C plus angle D, it is 360 degree. Okay, so with the help of compass surveying, what you are doing, you done all the thing, and when you added angle A, angle B, angle C and angle D, you have got 350. Okay, instead of getting 360 degree, how much you have got? You have got 59 degree. So what was the error? How much error it was? It was error of 1 degree. So in compass surveying, what you did is that you took this 1 degree. Okay, 1 degree divided by how many angles are there? 4 angles. Okay, it is equal to 0.25. okay, so what you did is that you should get this much of error to each angles. Okay, angle A, angle B, angle C and angle D. So when you added angle A, B, C plus D, after correction you have got 360 degree. So this is how what we have done in compass surveying and also in theodolite. Okay, open traverse and closed traverse. Okay, similarly here in advanced surveying, that too in geodetic surveying, we have different methods, but the basic principle is this one. Okay, the thing is that we have to distribute the errors to the respective angles. So here we have different geodetic surveying. Here it is little bit advanced, and here we will call some weights. Okay, some laws are there and some conditions are there, because this is an advanced one. So some definitions are there, so we will see. Okay, see those things, and we will do some calculations how to come out from the errors. Okay, so introduction, due to the faulty instrument, see, errors are occurred due to the human, it may be a instrument error, or it may be a human error. Okay, it may be some accidental error, or it may be some instrument error, correct? So errors will be occurred. We can't say that every time we will do with 100% precision. Okay, sometimes there will be error. So how to rectify this error? Okay, due to the faulty instrument, okay, or atmospheric variations and human mistakes. Okay, it is not every time possible to measure the observation, such as linear measure. Okay, linear measurement is like measuring with the help of, okay, chain, etc., and the angular measurement very precisely. Just now I said every time we can't do 100% correctly. And surveyor or civil engineer must know about the errors developed. One second, I will reduce the brightness. Must know about the errors developed and its eliminations. So we know that there are errors. We can see that there is some errors. Okay, so we, how to eliminate this error? Not only identifying there is some error, after identifying the error, we should eliminate. How we will eliminate, we will see. Okay, so note that the natural errors like wind after the earth culture and refractions are not controlled by human being, because these are the natural errors. So here we have three kinds of error important for MCQs. Okay, the first one is systematic error, second one is accidental error, and third one is the human error. Okay, systematic error. Okay, first we will go for the systematic error. Systematic errors, the error due to topographical map. Okay, so you may have any map in your home, okay, or in your office, or in, okay, so due to the shrinkage or sometime folding, okay, by folding also there will be a expansion, okay, or there will be a gap. You fold it, there will be a gap like this, okay. So expansion will be there, shrinkage will be there, so it will come under error, okay. Error caused by wrong length of chain, okay. Either it may be a too long or too short. It may be a too long or too short. Error due to the wrong scale of map. Suppose say that you have drawn a map or any plan with the 1:100 ratio, or 1:50, or 1:20, whatever. Okay. But while writing, you may write it 1:19. Or 1:18, or sometimes you have drawn this plan for 1:25 ratio, okay, and while writing you have written 1:20, so this leads to the error, a systematic error. Error caused by atmospheric refraction, okay. So say you are observing from here, there is another station, and the distance between this staff or a tower and the instrument is say around 30 km or 15 km. Okay, we are talking about geodetic surveying. Okay, so here the distance between the instruments will be low. And the thing is that here different types of air density. Okay, air density. So there may be some reflection of the light rays. So it may cause to some errors. It is not refraction, it is reflection. Sorry, refraction, it is correct. Refraction, reflection of light means bending of light ray. Okay. So another one is that error because of shrinkage or expansion of the aerial photography. Just either it may shrink or it may expand. And we have accidental error. Before going to accidental error, I will explain the human error. Okay. So in human error, improper attention of the observer. Okay. So you are the one who is holding in front of the instrument and you are taking the readings. Okay. Either it may be a pass surveying, geodetic surveying, total station, and whatever. So with improper attention, say you have got an angle of 20 degree, 19 minutes and 16 seconds, okay. So in a geodetic surveying, you will use a theodolite which have a least count of 1 second, okay. In experiment in write-up work also you have seen this one, okay. So instead of 16 second, what you have done, you have said that it is a 18 second. So it leads to the improper attention. And another important thing for MCQs, the following, he may ask, following errors or mistakes will come under the group. He may give option A, B, C, and D. Okay. He will give like this, and he may say, the following errors or mistakes belongs to, it may be a human mistakes, human error, accidental error, or systematic error. Like that, okay. Carelessness of the observer again, okay. Poor knowledge of handling the instrument, the person who don't know to handle the instruments, okay. The initially, if he don't know to do the leveling, means we can say that the person don't have any knowledge, okay. Unskilled and inexperienced observer, okay. Poor judgment and confusion in the mind of the observer, okay. See here, there is a star, okay. He is observing a star. And here actual reading, it is in the staff reading, it is 0.075, okay. The staff reading is 0.075, and he is getting confusion whether it is 0.80 or it is 0.070. actual reading it is 0.075, but he is saying that it is 0.70 or 0.80. he has confusion in his mind, so it also leads to the human mistake. The next one is that improper communication between the observer and the field party. These are the some kinds of human mistake. Then what are the accidental errors? So after solving the systematic error and the human error, error which is left, okay, that one we will call that as a accidental errors. Okay, that is error which remain as it even after the systematic errors and human errors are eliminated. Means even though after eliminating the human error and the systematic error, still there is any error, means that one we will call it as a accidental error. Okay, accidental error also termed as the random errors or compensating errors, since these errors tends to compensate each other. These errors are occurred because of combination of various causes and reasons which would be beyond the control and the capacity of the observer or the surveyor. Means, see here we are solving both the errors, okay, that is systematic error and human error. Okay, apart from that, we are trying to eliminate still, so there is some error we are trying to eliminate, but it is not happening, so which is beyond the user, okay, which is beyond the hand, in the hand of the user. So that those are called as the accidental error. Now these are the very important definitions, either it is offline mode or MCQs. 100% they will ask one question. If it is offline mode, means he will ask at least four definitions, one mark for each. Or MCQs means he may give some definition and may he say that whether which what is the meaning of that one. Okay, so one more thing is that these definitions, okay, 12 definitions are there now, very important, and I will explain them very neatly. Try to understand these things, because based on these things only we have the numericals. Okay, in that most probable value, this definition is most important, because we have n number of numericals based on this most probable value. And weight is most important. Normal equation, conditioned equation. So these four are most important. And I will give a good example such that it will remain in your mind whenever they ask. Means whenever I ask randomly, you can tell the definition of those things. Okay. So what do you mean by true error? So the difference between, okay, the difference between true value quantity and its observed value is known as true error. For example, see TE, it have a class strength of say how much, 59. Class strength is how much, 59. Okay, this one I will call it as a true value. Okay, but I don't know, just now I came to class and I counted the how many students are there, and I have got 58 students were present in the class. Okay, so this is the observed value. I am a teacher, okay, I came to class and I counted how many students are there. So after counting, I came to know that there are 58 students. So I give a thing is that the class strength is 58, but actually the class strength is how much, 59. So how much error was there? Error of one student. That is nothing but the true error. The difference between the true value, that is number of students in the class is 59 and observed is 58. Okay, the difference of these two, 59 minus 58, is how much, one. That we will call it as a true error. Okay, next one, most probable value. The value which has more chances of being true. The value which has more chance of being true than has any other, okay, is called as most probable value. So I will A, B, C, D, E. Okay, there are five students. Okay, say there are five students in randomly I took five students from your TE class. Okay, so I will ask them, what is your class strength? The A person will tell, it is 59. The B will say it is 57. C will say it is 59. D will say 59. And E will say it is 58. So here we can see more chances of being true is what? 59. Out of 5, 3 are saying 59. So this is the most probable value. That is, has more chance of being true. We will call it as a most probable value. Have you got this one? Say yes or no.
Yes, sir.
Have you got what you mean by most probable value?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Next one. Next, we have most probable or residual error. So next one, we have most probable error and residual error. First, we will see what you mean by most probable error. The quantity which is added, okay, the quantity which is added to most probable value and is, sorry, the quantity which is added or subtracted, okay, the quantity which is added or subtracted for the most probable value is called as most probable error. Okay, the most probable error fixes the limits. Okay, note that within this limit the true value of the quantity should lies. It means that 58 is there, okay, and the true value is how much? 59. Okay, so this minus this will equals to 1. That is most probable error. Then what you mean by residual error? It is the difference between the observed value of a quantity. That is how much it was. I observed it is 58, and the most probable value of the quantity, say most probable here, if I change here it to 57. Here it is 57, then the error will be equals to 1. That we will call it as the residual error. Difference between the observed value of a quantity and most probable value of a quantity is called as a residual error. Again, we have next step, that is dependent independent quantity. Okay, so as the name indicates, that independent quantity means it is independent of any other quantities like or readings. Okay, for example, benchmarks. Okay, benchmarks are the independent quantity, whereas the RLs for respective stations are dependent quantity. First, we will see on independent quantity, the quantity which value does not depend upon the value of other observed quantity. For example, benchmark. Okay, permanent benchmarks. So it never depend upon any other quantities. Okay, see, for example, with the help of the auto level or dumpy level, you are taking the levels of a called station A, and the benchmark is 100 here, and you got the level of say 101. Okay, and you shift the instrument somewhere, and again you take the reading, you got 102. Okay, so here your reading may change, but your benchmark will be fixed. So it never depends upon station A whether it is RL is greater than 100 or below the 100. So these are called as the independent quantity. It is totally independent and has no relation with any other observed quantity, and it does not make any difference or effect. See, here if your RL, yeah, it may be 101, 102, whatever it may be, but your benchmark will remain same. Does not make any difference or effect if the sum changes are in the observed quantity. Okay, the best example is the benchmark. Okay, next one is dependent quantity or conditioned quantity. Okay, the quantity whose value is depend upon the value of one or more quantities is termed as the condition quantity or dependent quantity. Okay, it is totally dependent over the other values of quantity and has a great relationship to other quantities. Okay, since it is not independent, it is also termed as a dependent quantity. For example, okay, it will having six sides. Okay, the total internal angle is, okay, it is a closed traverse, the total internal angle is 720. Okay, so if you take at least five readings, okay, the sixth reading we can directly subtract from the 720 degree. So, or it should be, if you take the sixth reading, it should be equals to 720 only. Okay, it should not be greater than 720 or it should not be less than 720, because the total inscribed angle or the total angles is equal to 720. Okay, the next important point is that weights. Okay, very very important this one. What do you mean by weight? Weight is an observation of its precision and trustworthiness. Okay, the quantity of each measurement result in evaluated with the help of number called weight. Okay, see here. Here I have A, B, C, D, and E. Okay, see, 59, okay, 57, and 58. Okay, see, how many students are saying that their class strength is 59? That is 1, 2, 3. Okay, how many students are saying that their class strength is 57? Only one student, E. How many students are saying that their class strength is 58? One. See, here its weightage is more. So what I'm going to explain about weight, it is weightage. Okay, weightage, it is more because three people are saying that it is 59 as compared to 57 and 58, because only one person is saying that the class strength is 57 and only one person is saying that the class strength is 58. But here the three people are saying that their class strength is 59. So higher the number, okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, so on up to n number, higher the number, higher the precision. Means, say that I will set up my instrument here. Okay, so there are 59 students. Okay, so if there are 59 students, I will call one by one and tell them to determine, with the help of the theodolite, I will tell them to determine the vertical angle. Okay, so see, if alpha equals to, say all the students say that the vertical angle is equals to alpha equals to 30 degree, its weight will be about 59, because all the students are saying that 59. It means that when you observed 59 times, you got the angle as alpha equals to 30 degree. For example, 40 degree. Okay, so it is, I will call weight as 10. Okay, here weight was how much? 59. Here I will call weight as 10. Means when I observed it 10 times, I have got angle alpha equals to 40 degree, or 10 students said that the alpha equals to 40 degree. So higher the number, higher the precision. Okay, this weight is most important. Okay, of which the quantity of each measurement result is evaluated with the help of the number called as weight. Okay, for example, if a certain observation has a weight 6, okay, for example, if certain observation has a weight 6, okay, listen very carefully, it means that 6 times It is 6 times as much as an observation having weight 1. Means, say that alpha equals to 30 degree has a weight of how much? 6. Okay. Alpha equals to 31 degree having weight equals to 1. Okay. It is 6 times true that alpha equals to 31. Note that the weight is expressed in terms of number, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Weight of the higher number represents higher precision or higher accuracy, and lower number represent lower accuracy or lower precision. Then we have direct observation and indirect observation. The observation which are made directly on a determined quantity is called as direct observation. For example, single measurement of direction or angle. Okay, without any shifting, we can directly take the measurement. Okay, from say station to station B, if you take the direct measurement, you will call direct length, or if you calculate the direct distance or any angle, you'll call it as a direct observation. In indirect observation, you do many deductions. Okay, and for example, say here A, I will call this one as B dash, then I will call this one as B. Okay, first I will measure this one. I want the distance between B and B dash. First, I will measure the distance between A and B. Say this is 30 meter, and I have the distance between A and B, that is 10 meter. So from 30 meter, you are deducting the 10 meter, you are getting 20 meter. So this is called as indirect observation. The observation from which observed value is deduced or deducted from the measurement of some related quantity is termed as indirect observation. Okay. Value of quantity. The value so obtained after corrections for all the known errors is called as observed value of quantity. Next, true value of a quantity is nothing but when the value of the quantity is totally free from all the errors is known as true value quantity. Then normal equation and condition equation is nothing but the we form the normal equations, okay, that is ax plus bx, b or ax square plus bx plus c, because these are the normal equation. Conditions equations are that there will be some condition that a will not be equals to 0, b will not be equals to 0. So we will see these types in the numericals. Okay, and another important thing, so these all are the definitions. So definitions are very simple. Okay, just go through it, and in terms of if it is MCQs or offline mode, 100% you will ask it. Then okay, how to determine the probable errors. Okay, one second. Or he may ask the forums. Okay, how you will determine the probable errors? Okay, when your weights are equal, unequal. Once I will show what you mean by weights. Okay. Here. First, I will explain this weight, means I will show some numericals. I will not solve the numerical, I will show the numerical what you mean by weight. So I will call this one is a row number 1, row number 2, row number 3, row number 4, 5, 6. Okay. So row number 1 took an angle, okay, that is 40 degree, 20 minutes, 8 seconds. So how many times he took? Only one time he took. Row number 2, he got an angle, that is 40 degree, 20 minutes, 10 seconds. How many time he took? One time. So all the 6 students took the angle, and how many times they took? Only one time. So their weights are 1. Okay. Now, yeah, see, row number 1, row number 2, row number 3. Row number 1 did a horizontal measurement And how many times he did? Only one time he did. So we will call it as weight equals to 1. So rule number 2, he did an observation and he got horizontal angle as 40 degree, 30 minutes, 30 seconds. How many times? 2 times. So his weight is 2. So another person, third rule number, he did, and how many times he did? He did 3 times. So his weight is how much? 3 times. Some other numericals. And these kinds of numeric equations you already solved. Okay, equation number 1, equation number 2, equation number 3. Directly put in the calculator, you will get the value of B. Yeah. Numericals are very simple. Here also there is one example for the weights. Okay, so angle A, how many times it is observed? 4 times. Okay, so weight it is how much? 4. A plus B, okay, the combined weight is how much? 3 times. Okay, B plus C, the combined weight is how much? 2 times. A plus B plus C, the combined weight is how much? 1 times. Weights. Here you can see, A, it has how much weight? 3 weights. Angle B, 2 weights. Angle C, 4 weights. Angle D, 2 weights. So, this is how, what we call as weight or weightage. So he asked very less times, okay, and possible of getting these questions are chances is very low. Then also we don't want to give any chance, okay. So he may ask that to determine the probable errors, okay. For the first condition is that for direct observation of equal weights, okay. Equal weight means angle A, B, C, D. 4 angles are there. There is weights are 1, 1, 1, 1, or it may be 2, 2, 2, 2, or it may be 5, 5, 5, 5. So having with the equal weight. So just remember this formula. Okay. For MCQs, just remember the formula. That is ES equals to, and it is already derived, okay. You don't to do any some derivations, it is already derived one. That is ES equals to plus or minus 0.6745 square root of E, summation of V square upon N minus 1. Okay, where is A is number of observation in series. Okay, how many times you observed. V is nothing but the difference between mean of this series and the value of single observation. Means 1 plus 2 plus 3, how many readings are there? 3 readings are there. Okay, you are taking the mean or average. ES is nothing but the probable error of single observation. Okay, for only single observation. So, and if you ask any average error, okay, probable average error average. So, it is ES upon square root of n. Okay. Just remember the formula, ES equals to plus or minus 0.6745 square root of summation of V square upon N minus 1. Okay. For second case, if you have unequal weights, okay, just now I showed you unequal weights, that is A, B, C, D, 4 angles are there. A is having 1 weight, B is having 3 weight, C is having 2 weight, and D is having, okay. If it is unequal weight means, you have to use this formula. Then the third case is that indirect observation on independent quantity. Okay, we have to use this formula. So quickly we will use one numerical, and this is most important. Maximum if he asks means he will ask from this type of numerical. See here. Problems on probable error. The following observations were recorded for an angle under the identical conditions. So these are the angles, only single observations. Okay, this is single observation, and he is saying that probable error of single observation, probable error of mean, and most probable value of the angle. Okay, means here we have to use this formula. Okay, probable error of the single observation, and he is asking the probable error of average. So we use these two errors. So what he had thing, what we have to do is that we have to do some tabular column. That is one. This is first observation, second observation, third, fourth, fifth, sixth. Write in a vertical manner. Okay, then do average or mean. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Add all these six values and divide it by 6. So we will get the average. And this is V. Okay, what you do? It is a difference. Okay, difference of observed minus average. Here we can see V. Okay, it is a difference. So what you do? 142 degree 20 minutes and 0 seconds. Okay, minus 142 degree 20 minutes. 46.67 seconds. So you will get the value of V. Then we have to do V square. V square. Same thing. This minus this, you will get this. This minus this. Again, the same thing is done. And one more thing. If anybody having calculator means, you can just check. If you take the square of this one, okay, if you take the square of that one, you won't get 36 minutes 18 seconds. Okay, so the procedure for calculating that one is little bit different. See, if you take in calculator, that is 0 degree 0 minute 46.67 degree, and if you do the square of this one, means you won't get this value. Okay, so the procedure for doing that one is a little bit different. I will write the procedure here and take the screenshot of that one. Okay, what you have to do is, first you have to convert this degree into radian. Okay, that is 46.67, okay, divided by 60 into 60. Okay, first you have to do divide this one. Then you will get in terms of radian, that is 0.01296. Okay, then what you have to do, then you have to square this one. This is first step. The second step is that 0.01296, then you square it, because we have V and we want V square. Okay, see here, we want V square. After squaring this one, we will get 1.680 × 10⁻⁴. Okay. First, what you did? You did this conversion, that is from degree to radian. Then you squared it. The next step is that from radian to degree, that is 1.680 × 10⁻⁴. Okay. Multiplied by 60, multiplied by 60, you will get 0.60502. Okay, after getting this one, what you do in your calculator, there will be a degree button. Okay, press that degree button. Okay, you will get in terms of this reading, that is 36 minute 18.08 second. Okay, just take the screenshot of this one, because if you go directly squaring with this one, means you won't get the value. Okay, I hope you have taken the screenshot. Okay, this is press degree button. Okay, so you will get V. Then what you do, square it, you will get the value. This one, square it, you will get this one. Okay, the summation of V will be equals to 0. and we need summation of v square. Okay, so we have got all the values. Okay, so just substitute that of v square, we have already just calculated that one. Then n is equal to number of observation. How many observations are there? 1 2 3 4 5 6. Okay, 6 times observations are there, so we have got the error. Okay, now probable error by mean of a mean. Okay, mean error, so we have a formula, that is em equals to es upon square root of n. So substituting all those value, we have got that is 13 degree 20.4 seconds. So we have calculated these two, then we have left with the most probable value. So the most probable value will be this one, that is mean one. Okay, this. Okay, 142 degree 20 minutes 46.67 seconds, plus or minus this average. So your angle will lies between, okay, your angle will lies between 142 degree 34 minutes 7 seconds or 142 degree 7 minutes 26.27 seconds. So that it may be either it may be this one or this one. So this is how we'll find the most probable values. Next one we have, see here they have taken the levels. Okay, the staff rating as a 1.322 1.346 1.352. so these are the staff ratings. How many observations are there? 8 observations are there. Okay, so what you have to do, you have to take the mean of it, you will get the v. Okay, then we have, you have to square it, you will get v square. Okay, then the same thing, you substitute, you will get the most probable error for single observation, mean error. This is how we do in the calculation of the errors. Okay, so the next important thing is that weights. Okay, one thing is that whatever I explain here, you won't understand this one. Only you will understand when you will solve the numericals. Okay, so how to understand this one is that first thing that we have to read this one, these laws. Okay, then you have to go for solving the numericals. Instantly solving the numerical, then again you have to go back and read these laws. Then only you will understand this one. Okay, so quickly we will see into this one. The first law is that the weight of arithmetic mean. So we are talking about laws of weight. Okay, the weight of arithmetic mean of the number of observations. Okay, not a single observation here, there are n number of observations. Their arithmetic mean, arithmetic means you know already 1 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus so on up to n divided by n. Okay, is equals to sum of individual weights. Okay, sum of individual weights of the number of observations. Yeah, arithmetic mean will be equals to sum of individual weights. Okay, the second law is that weight of arithmetic mean of number of observation will be equals to summation of number of individual weights of observation. Okay, third one is that when all the signs, whether it may be a positive or negative, is either added or subtracted. Okay, when all the signs of equations are changed when the equation is added to a constant or subtracted to a constant. Okay, later we have some constants. Okay, we will see those things also. It remains as it is. Okay, whether you add or subtract, it remains the same thing. Okay, when the quantity of a given weight is divided, okay, this is important, little bit important. When the quantity of a given weight is divided by a factor of or a constant, okay, say it is given as 5, okay, and it is divided by a constant, then the weight of the result is equal to product means multiplying product of given weight and the square of the factor or constant. For example, let the weight be 8. Okay, that is alpha equals to one angle you have measured, that is alpha equals to 40 degree 20 minutes 30 second, and its weight is 8 and its constant is much 5. Okay, so when you divide, that is alpha upon 5, when you divide by a constant, it will be equals to say 40 degree 20 minutes 30 second, that is 8 degree 4 minutes 6 seconds. What you got? 8 degree 4 minutes 6 seconds. But you don't know what is the weight of this angle. Okay, you know the weight of this angle. Okay, that is alpha. Alpha equals how much? 40 degree 20 minutes 30 second. Okay, so its weight we know, it is 8. Okay, but we don't know the weight of this one. How we will weight multiplied by square of constant is equals to 200. So the weight of 80 degree 4 minutes 6 second is what? 200. Okay, a little bit understanding this one is quite difficult. So simultaneously solving you will come to know. Okay, so when the quantity of a given weight is multiplied by, so when the quantity of a weight is multiplied by a factor, okay, or any constant, then the weight of result, okay, means the angle which you are getting, okay, its weight will be equal to the ratio of given weight to square of the factor. See how much? 40 degree 20 30 seconds, its weight is 8 and factor is 5. Okay, if you multiply, okay, constant, that is constant is how much? 5. If you multiply it by alpha angle, its angle is how much? 201 degrees 30 seconds. So we don't know the weight of this one. Okay, how will you find out that one? It is 8 upon 5 square. In previous time, what we have done, we have 8 multiplied by 5 square we have did. Okay, we have got 200. Okay, but here what we are doing, here we are doing 8 divided by 5 square, which we are getting 0.32. so the weight of this angle is how much? 0.32. Then the weight of the algebraic sum of two or more quantities will be equals to reciprocal of sum of the individual weights. Okay, we have numerical on that one. When an equation is multiplied by its own weight, then the weight of the resulting equation will be equals to the reciprocal of the equations. We have another example. So quickly we will see three numericals. Example on weights. He may ask for MCQs. Okay, these are very simple one. Angle A is measured 6 times. Okay, the following angles, the values of the angles and its weights. Okay, he has given angle and its weight. Okay, determine the arithmetic mean. If he say arithmetic means, you should get in your mind that is simple one. That is what you do: add all these angles and divide it by 6. Okay. So here what he did is that 40 degree 20 40 20 40 20 40 20 40 20 everything is there now. So he just took the average of seconds. Okay, don't do this one. If it exceeds, actually it will not exceed. If there are near to exceed means you will get some error. So what you do, add all the angles and divide it by number of observations. Okay, so 6. So how much you have got? That is adding these all 6 divided by 6 equals to 40 degree 20 minutes 9 second. Okay, so from the law of weight we know that weight of arithmetic mean will be equals to number of observation, very first law. Okay, so the weight of this angle, new angle, it will be equals to 6. Sum of the weights. Next one, determine the weight of the arithmetic weighted arithmetic mean of the following observation of the angle whose weights are given. So weights are given theta 1, its weights are 3. So what you have the arithmetic mean, what you do, 1 plus 2 plus 3, add all these three things, so you will get the weighted arithmetic mean as equals to 6. Next, determine the weight of the sum and the difference. Okay, first we will see sum and next we will see difference. 40 degree, 20 seconds having weight of, here we have two angles, okay, that is 40 degree, 20 minutes 30 second and its weight is 6. Okay, another one we have 30 degree, 30 minutes and its weight is 6. Okay, so law says that the weight of quantities added algebraically will be equals to reciprocal of summation of individual weights. Okay, the first one, weight of the sum, that is add angles. Okay, you have got new angle is 71 degree 0 minute 40 second, but you don't know weight of this one. So how to determine weight of this one? That is 1 divided by weight of this angle is how much? 6. Okay, weight of this one is how much? 4. Okay, 1 upon reciprocal, that is 1 upon 6 plus 1 upon 4. 1 upon 6 plus 1 upon 4. So you have got weight as, after solving, you will get weight as 12 upon 5. Means when you added this one. Similarly, when you subtract the two angles, that is 40 degree 20 30 minutes 20 seconds and 30 degree 30 minutes 20 seconds, you have, after subtracting, you have got 10 degree 0 minute 0 second, but you don't know the weight of this one. So how will you calculate? Same procedure, means reciprocal of individual weight. So you have got, that is 15 upon 5. So this is about weights. Okay, similarly you can go for this one also. So take 10 minutes.